Capcom, we're go for landing.
Eagle Houston, you're go for landing, over.
It was an incredible achievement for humankind.
Eagle Houston, you're looking good.
After 21 hours and 36 minutes on the surface of the moon, it was time for the first people to walk here, Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin, to start heading home.
You won't believe it, but we're using technology weaker than our microwaves to snap stunning pictures of the moon. We're now diving into how this basic radar from the Green Bank Telescope captures incredible scenes of places like the Tycho Crater and the Apollo 15 landing site. Despite its low power, this radar can see objects just 5 meters wide on the moon's surface. What hidden mysteries does the Apollo 11 site hold today, silently waiting in the dark? Let's explore, let's analyze, let's reveal the untold stories of the moon's legendary sites. Advanced imaging reveals new depths. These pictures show detailed views of places like the Tycho Crater and the Apollo 15 landing site. What's amazing is that these images were taken with a radar beam that is actually weaker than the ones used in our microwave ovens at home. Yet the radar from the Green Bank Telescope could detect objects as small as 5 meters on the moon's surface. This highlights just how advanced our current radar technology for space research is. As we marvel at our current technology, we have to ask, what secrets are still hidden on the moon, waiting to be uncovered? For instance, these detailed images allow scientists to study the texture, composition, and even the history of the moon's craters and rocks. They can identify areas with different types of minerals and determine which parts of the surface have been impacted by meteorites. Yet, these achievements lead to another question. How will this new knowledge shape our future plans for the moon? The high-quality images are not just for understanding the moon's past, but also for planning future missions. With better pictures, space agencies can pick safer landing spots and identify the best areas for scientific study. These advances are crucial as they bring us closer to possibly setting up bases on the moon or mining its resources, but the technology doesn't just help with missions, it also brings space exploration into our homes. With the help of these detailed images, people worldwide can get a closer look at the moon like never before. This helps spark interest in space and inspires the next generation of scientists and explorers. And yet, even with these fantastic strides, there are still challenges. Scientists are constantly working to improve the technology further, making it even more accurate and efficient. Every step forward opens up new possibilities and, of course, new questions. What might the next generation of moon studies uncover? The journey is just beginning. Recently, Japan's mission called Smart Lander for Investigating Moon tried something new by using advanced cameras to make a very precise landing on the moon. Even though there were some problems, like landing on its side, the mission still managed to send back images to Earth, giving us a fresh look at the moon's surface. An exciting part of the mission was a small rover named LEV-2. This rover could change from a ball shape into a vehicle that could move around, showing off some really creative ways to explore the moon. The pictures taken from different moon missions are not just advanced, they are also extremely important for science. For example, images captured by the Odysseus lander from a company called Intuitive Machines, which landed near the moon's south pole, show just how complex the terrain in that area is. The south pole is especially interesting because there are areas that are always in shadow, which might contain water ice, a crucial resource for future moon missions. These images help scientists understand the layout and materials of the moon's surface better, paving the way for even more detailed explorations in the future. Let's take a closer look at the moon's latest images. The Dark Side of Lunar Secrets. These new, clear pictures give scientists a chance to look again at the places where past missions landed, but with much more detail. For example, the latest radar images of where Apollo 15 touched down show not just the part of the spacecraft left behind, but also small details of the moon's surface around it, like rocks and tiny craters. Seeing things so clearly is a huge help when planning to send people or robots to the moon again. With missions like the Artemis program aiming to send astronauts back to the moon, knowing exactly where it's safe to land is very important. These sharp images make a big difference because they help scientists find and choose the safest landing spots. They can closely examine the area for any dangers and even find resources like water ice that future explorers might need. Recent advances in technology seen in the latest space missions will significantly impact how we design and build future moon explorers and vehicles. For example, the small but powerful cameras used in the SLIM project show how future missions could use high-tech gear while keeping things light and compact, an essential feature for space travel. These breakthroughs also point to a future where self-operating machines become the norm. The LEV-2 rover is a good example, suggesting that more advanced automated moon explorers could be coming soon. The new images from the moon's surface are a huge step forward in our ability to study and understand our closest space neighbor. These pictures, taken with state-of-the-art technology, provide stunning views and important information that will help plan future missions. As government and private space organizations continue to push lunar exploration, improving imaging technology will remain crucial for unlocking the mysteries of the moon and even looking beyond it. Thanks to advanced radar, precise landings, and the latest rovers, the surface of the moon has been mapped out with amazing detail. These advancements have given us a much clearer picture of what the moon is like and are preparing us for a future where people and machines will work together to explore the most fascinating parts of the moon. As we get ready for this thrilling new era of space exploration, the images and data we gather today will lay the groundwork for future discoveries. Every clear picture and accurate map helps us understand the moon's landscape better, setting the stage for smarter, more efficient missions. This teamwork between technology and human curiosity is not just about setting foot in new places, it's about making every step count towards reaching bigger scientific goals. But that's not the end of the story. These missions and tools are more than just explorations. They are the stepping stones for a deeper and more complete understanding of what the moon holds. NASA radio communicated with the Eagle saying, "Houston, everything looks good." After spending over 21 hours on the moon's surface, astronauts Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin got ready to head back to Earth. NASA started the countdown. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, abort stage, engine arm ascent, proceed. Now discover what else the astronauts left behind. The forgotten relics of Apollo 11. This story explores what the astronauts left behind at one of the most important places in history, a place that remains untouched to this day. As they lifted off, Buzz Aldrin looked out the window and saw the engine's exhaust blowing moon dust around, accidentally knocking over the American flag. This flag, made of nylon and not designed for the moon's conditions, was just an ordinary one bought from a government catalog. To keep it upright, they used a horizontal crossbar, since there is no wind on the moon to make it wave, but that wasn't all they left behind. Along with the flag, there were a few non-scientific items with special meaning. For example, a metal plaque with the signatures of the Apollo 11 crew and President Richard Nixon was attached to the ladder of the descent stage. The astronauts also left some smaller objects, each with its own symbolic value, which had been tucked away in a pocket on Buzz Aldrin's spacesuit. And believe it or not, Aldrin almost forgot to leave these things on the moon. As he climbed back up the ladder to the lunar module, Armstrong had to remind him. So Aldrin quickly dropped the items onto the lunar surface, adding a few more human touches to the moon's landscape. To honor the three courageous astronauts who tragically lost their lives in a fire during a pre-launch test, a patch from the Apollo 1 mission was placed on the moon. This fire, which happened 2.5 years before, took the lives of all three crew members on board. In a similar gesture of remembrance, two medals were also left behind to honor Soviet cosmonauts Yuri Gagarin and Vladimir Komarov, who each died in separate space-related accidents. Even though the Cold War created a lot of tension between countries, these acts were meant to show a shared respect for everyone who had dared to explore the unknown of space. In the same spirit of global cooperation, a small silicon disc was also left on the moon. This disc was special because it carried messages of goodwill from the leaders of 73 different countries, showing a worldwide desire for unity. It also included the names of key members of the US Congress involved in funding NASA and senior staff at NASA, highlighting the teamwork that made space exploration possible. But that wasn't all. A gold olive branch was also placed on the moon as a symbol of peace for all of humanity. Along with these symbolic items, practical tools were also left behind for scientific research. One such tool was a seismometer, an instrument designed to detect and record moonquakes. This tool could measure the strength, duration, and direction of these moonquakes and send the data back to Earth using solar-powered panels. The harsh environment of the moon presented unexpected challenges for the equipment. The seismometer stopped sending data just 3 weeks after the successful moon landing. Most likely, it overheated under the intense midday sun on the moon. Unlike Earth, where the atmosphere helps to regulate temperatures, the moon's surface experiences extreme swings between hot and cold. This makes it even harder for equipment to survive. Next, explore how astronauts managed in the tough moon environment. Legacy and leftovers. Imagine being in a place where the environment can spread and hold on to things during the night. It's quite an interesting setup. Then there's the lunar laser retro reflector, a special kind of mirror that reflects light straight back to where it came from. This tool allows scientists on Earth to aim a laser at it and the light bounces back to our planet. Since we know how fast light travels, this clever device helps us measure the exact distance between the Earth and the Moon. What's truly remarkable is that this is the only piece of equipment from that mission still working today. But what about the other tools the astronauts used? Well, they're mostly remembered by the marks they left on the moon. The crew also gathered rocks and drilled into the moon's surface to see how hard it was. During their trip, they even set up a special fabric to capture and study the solar wind, which they could only do once they were out of Earth's protective magnetic field. However, this wasn't the end of their efforts. The team continued to conduct experiments, each one revealing more secrets about the moon's surface and the space around it. When the astronauts came back from their mission, they took just the flagpole, leaving the fabric part of the flag behind on the moon. Close to where their lunar lander touched down, there's a spread-out collection of things they discarded, basically space trash left behind. During their mission, they gathered many rock samples to bring back for study. To make space for these samples, they had to toss out some of their used equipment that they didn't need anymore. They also left behind the black and white camera that had captured historic moments like their first steps and the raising of the flag. This camera now sits on the moon, set to stay there forever. Along with the equipment and personal items, the astronauts left several scientific experiments that were meant to keep collecting data even after they left. One of the most meaningful things they left behind is their footprints pressed into the moon's dust. These footprints have come to stand for human exploration and achievement, remaining untouched on the moon as a lasting reminder of this incredible journey. The importance of this journey is huge. You can still see the footprints left by the astronauts in the moon's dust, showing a path that goes far from where they first landed. As the astronauts' walk on the moon was almost over, Neil Armstrong decided to take an unplanned side trip to the small West Crater, a spot they hadn't originally planned to explore. After the astronauts left the surface of the moon, many people thought the Apollo 11 landing area in the Sea of Tranquility would stay almost the same for a very long time. On the moon, things change much more slowly than on Earth because there's no air or weather to speed things up. But now, more than 50 years later, we can see that the area looks a little different. This is mainly because the sun constantly shines strong ultraviolet light on it. Without any air to block this sunlight, it slowly changes how things appear. Let's see what remains from those early moon missions. Discoveries from the strange orbit. NASA's Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter, a spacecraft that flies around the moon, has been closely watching where humans first walked on the moon. It has taken very clear pictures of where the astronauts left their footprints and placed their experiments. You can still see the paths and dark marks where Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin walked and worked. It's incredible to think these marks are still visible from space. The spacecraft also spotted the remains of experiments left behind by the astronauts. One experiment was for measuring moonquakes, and another helped scientists measure the distance from Earth to the moon very accurately. These experiments provided a lot of useful information, and some are still helping scientists today, but this isn't even the most surprising part. The paths the astronauts made covered a very small area, much smaller than a city block. This shows how limited their exploration was during that first visit. Later missions allowed astronauts more time to explore and even use vehicles to drive around so they could reach much farther from their landing spots. Scientists have learned a lot from the rocks and soil samples the astronauts brought back. They discovered that this part of the moon once had volcanoes and flowing lava. These samples are like clues to the moon's fiery past, almost like a story written in stone waiting for us to read. But here's the fascinating part. All this information comes from just looking at pictures taken from orbit. The moon might seem quiet and unchanging, but these photos remind us of the brave explorers of the past and show us how even the smallest footprints can lead to big discoveries about our universe. Sunlight plays a big role in affecting the materials used in space missions. For example, the bright red, white, and blue colors of the US flag are believed to have faded over time. These materials have also been through some of the most extreme conditions imaginable, dealing with huge swings in temperature. They face scorching heat up to 100 degrees Celsius for long periods, then endure total darkness with freezing temperatures as low as minus 150 degrees Celsius. Because of this, the nylon flag and other materials are probably now torn and falling apart. These items have likely broken down quite a bit and are covered with dust. But here's the surprising part. What's left at this site still sparks curiosity and wonder. Based on what we know, this area, while preserved as well as many historic sites on Earth, is incredibly hard to study in detail. The special conditions on this distant world make it an interesting but tough place to explore, standing out sharply from the archaeological sites we're familiar with here on our planet. But that's not the hardest challenge yet. The extreme temperatures and unique environment continue to surprise scientists, offering more questions than answers. Exploring this site is like stepping into the unknown, where every new discovery could change what we think we know about space and preservation, and there's more. As scientists try to learn from this mysterious site, they face many obstacles such as limited access and the harsh conditions. The site is in a place where regular exploration methods don't work well. This means they have to come up with creative new ways to study and understand what's there, making every step forward a real challenge. But the mysteries don't end there. The more they learn, the more they realize just how different this site is compared to anything we have seen on Earth. The conditions that have kept it preserved are so unusual that it continues to stand out, demanding a closer look. What if this site isn't just unique, but evidence of extraterrestrial life? Like, comment and subscribe for more!